I'm Kelly, and I'm getting Diva Curl at Allura. Can't wait to see my results.
Hi, my name is Katrina.
The first thing that went through my mind when I saw Kelly's hair, her hair is uneven and curl. It is very dry looking.
So I'm going to identify your type of curl as Botticelli curl, which is a variegated curl.
I wear my hair curly sometimes. It's sort of difficult to do rather than straightening. I need to add some curls. I've always had curly hair, but my mom's a hairdresser, and like even so that I had curly hair, believe it or not, she used to give me perms back in the day. And that was for the same reason, because it was curly in some places and not the other. I hope to accomplish an easier way for me to wear my hair curly.
I want curly hair to people to know that you can achieve the look that you want.
Plus it's summer's coming. Beach.
Yeah.
Diva Curl has 3 different formulas, and I'm going to show her how to cocktail those formulas according to her hair. Okay, so Kelly, it's really important that you saturate your hair. So the first step we did was we used the Buildup Buster, and what the Buildup Buster is going to do is break through any parabens, waxes, any buildup caused by other products that will prevent Diva Curl from penetrating into the cortex of your hair and expanding with water. You want to break down those other products that are preventing your hair from really curling and allowing moisture to penetrate into your hair.
So the next thing you're going to do, you're going to rinse all this out. You're going to notice having bubbles in the sink. And then rinsing out anything that's going to prevent Diva Curl from working. Look at all those bubbles!
So the bubbles come afterwards.
So this is really important. Don't wring out your hair. This product works solely on water. It needs as much H2O so that it can expand and then compact your curls into groupings.
Step 2 with Kelly's hair, we went into the No Poo product. Now, No Poo is your cleanser.
So this is the No Poo, this is the shampoo cleanser part. You're gonna put it around your little baby hairs first.
Make sure you concentrate on the scalp.
Split it right here, right behind.
And then really rake through your end.
I'm gonna slide it right down. Remember, it does not bubble up.
Okay. So this, the way that you're doing that, because it would feel like, I think to most people, like you're not getting your hair washed with it not bubbling up, so you have to do it in that.
Mm-hmm. In that order.
In that fashion. Order, okay.
Here's the thing. So curly hair people tend to not have as many sebaceous glands as a straight hair person. So if we don't have as many sebaceous glands or oil glands, isn't that why our hair frizz out so much? Because we don't have as much moisture, right?
It makes a lot of sense.
Right. Because you always hear about a straight hair person saying, my hair is so greasy, right? But have you ever heard of a curly hair person saying that?
No.
You ever hear a curly hair person saying, my hair is so greasy? Because the hair is dry. It's naturally dry. So we're going to just check the water content of this. It's not dripping. We need more water. So we're just going to like drip some water. We are not rinsing the product out. We're trying to add into the product. So if you don't have enough water in the product itself, it's not going to be able to expand. It's not going to be able to compact the curls. It's not going to be able to group those curls together. So the more water you have in conjunction with the No Poo shampoo, the better the curl contraction will be.
So this squishing sound is just indicating the amount of moisture in our hair, which is amazing. It's really soaking it up. Can kind of sound like a wet sneaker, I guess.
Yeah, so, totally.
It's so funny.
It is raining today.
Right. All I'm doing is just raking the No Poo through the hair. The reason being is that I want every strand to get to know its neighbor and be able to pull it in and say, hey, come on over for Thanksgiving dinner. Step 3 with Kelly's hair, we're still sticking with the original conditioner. So really rake through everything. Make sure that you're looking for ribboning versus spidering. Your spidering is going to be those unruly pieces that don't want to join in with the groups. It's going to turn into frizz once you diffuse it, and you don't want that. So what you're looking for is the ribboning. And ribboning is just that. It looks smooth in texture. It's grouped together, and it doesn't look like it's spidering, which is this. So there's a comparison. You can see all those little tiny flyaways. This will turn into frizz. This will not. So this is ribboning.
Okay.
And this is spidering.
You want it to be really soft and riveting. Really soft and riveting. And you just want to kind of like, once in a while, test it, squeeze it, squish, squish, you know, listen to that wet sneaker sound. And just incorporate that part to signify that you do have enough moisture in your hair. Now remember, you cannot wring your hair out in between these steps. It needs to be dripping. So introduce water where needed, when needed. Test it, grab a hold of your hair, see if it's dripping in your hand. If it's not, you don't have enough water in your hair for the product to expand. So add water gently to your hair and then keep working at it. With Kelly's hair, she struggles with the top being super straight and the back being super curly.
I have curl down here, but not up here. Well, I just said I'd like my curls underneath though. That was pretty sweet. Yeah.
With the step four, we're going to do the ultra defining gel. I want this curl to hold. So you're just going to concentrate around the forehead, around those unruly pieces, and then you won't see as many little fuzzies.
You're gonna glaze it right over just like that. Glaze it right down and up underneath where you lay your head on the pillow, where the sun hits it, and where you push it around a lot. That's the areas that you want to address. And then all you do is just literally rake right through.
Who's taking me out tonight?
Okay, so I squish everything because what it does is it joins in with the water and then it kind of like spreads to the adjacent hairs that don't have gel. So when you squish it and you hear that, you're spreading it. You're encouraging curl. You can see her hair curling. This is amazing. This is great.
I can't wait.
Really, really wanted to encourage more of that curl right at the top. So it's ideal for you to flip your hair upside down and then just use your hands and squeeze up really as close to your scalp as possible. And what you're looking for is dripping. Even in the back, you're gonna turn your head, squeeze it until the water stops dripping. And then you're gonna take a microfiber towel. And the microfiber towel isn't going to be as abrasive as a regular terry cloth towel. It's not gonna act like Velcro. You want something that's super soft. You wanna still talk to the hair. You don't want necessarily to shout at the hair because it's gonna shout back still. So let's talk to it with something soft.
Let's talk.
Yes, here we go. So you're gonna squeeze.
Talk to me, baby.
You're gonna scrunch until you feel moisture come through and let go.
And then let the release. Is it curly?
Wow.
And squeeze.
You're just gonna scrunch and let go all the way around until you get the excess moisture out.
Just yes.
The curls came out beautifully. It's talking to you. It's talking back.
It's excited.
Right, it's excited. It's amazing. It was amazing, but she still had a little bit of flatness around here. In order for me to give her volume around that area, we use the Diva Curl Clips.
Okay.
And slide it right in. And close. If you get some unruly pieces like these,
okay.
It's still wet. See this piece right here?
Mm-hmm.
You see where it's coming from? You kind of like lift it up and then you look at where it's the closest to whatever grouping that you want it to be with. You're gonna lift that grouping right up. And if it comes with other pieces, fine. Just join them together and twist it with it. Doesn't matter which way you twist it. It just, what matters is that you're trying to group them, regroup them together and then just kind of scrunch. And if you like how you clip, which this looks really cute,
okay.
You know, you got some straighter pieces right here, but it's totally fine.
So twisting is big, I feel like, with that.
Twisting is huge, because twisting is curls. It would be ideal if you use a little bit of hairspray. You don't have to. I like to personally, so then it will control any flyaways that try to get away from the groupings, and it'll ensure more of a compact curl. We're doing a 15 to 20 minute diffusing for Kelly. All right, I'm gonna have you come right over to my chair.
love.
We're gonna gently pull these clips out. I like the Mr. Right spray because for you, your hair.
I suggested to her that she should use the Mr. Right spray. Spray it all the way around her hair and just scrunch. And then use the tips of her fingers, go up underneath the hair, right at the scalp, and just give it a good wiggle. It will look like it's expanding a little bit, but what it's doing is it's breaking up this cast where you're not touching it. Basically telling the groups of curls to wake up. Break all of this up. Usually have little baby hairs right there, right?
Yeah.
Are they gone?
They're gone.
Yay!
It's amazing.
You flip upside down and we're just gonna do...
I knew I was gonna have to do that one more time.
Styling cream, you put a little pump on the back of your hand. While your hair is still moist with the Mr. Right spray, you take a little dab. And where I showed you how to compact your flyaways with the adjacent curls, you're gonna twist it back in, scrunch it, and leave it alone. The key is to leave your curls alone. Don't brush it, don't mess with it, don't try to rake through it, don't let anybody else try to rake through your hair.
There you go.
Can I touch it now?
Little.
No.
Yeah.
No.
No.
I have to be nice to my curls.
Yes,
my curls love me.
Right. They do. They're showing you love, right?
Curly hair, don't care, you know?
No. I was astonished at how her hair actually reacted. I thought it was going to be definitely straighter, but it reacted so well that I think she's gonna have so much luck with this product.
I can't even tell you how much knowledge I have just about my hair, like just today in these last couple hours, and I'm excited. It's a new look, it's fun, it's my hair feels like healthy, and I'm ready for summer. Bring it on.
What I love most about teaching people how to love their curls is the psychological aspect of it. I've struggled for many years with my natural curls. I've been bullied because who's ever heard of a half Asian little girl with super curly hair? Nobody. I mean, I always have to sometimes explain to people, well, that's where the Japanese straightening treatment came from, and then people laugh at me. So it's, so I had to fight through my entire life with my curls, and I finally, after going through all the straightening treatments and burning my scalp and chemically hurting my body, it wasn't worth it. It was more worth it just to talk to my curls and accepting who they are, what they are, and just letting it be. Be happy with yourself. When you're happy with yourself, your curls will reflect it.
I love my curls.
Don't do that.
Peace out.